What's up, everybody? Welcome back. Now, if you are looking for something to play on your Nintendo Switch, I do suggest Crysis Remastered on the Switch. It is a very good port, in my opinion. I did have a video on it in my last upload a few days ago. I do suggest checking it out. One thing I want to point out before we get into Metroid is that in Crysis Remastered, if you're looking to play this game for the first time on the Switch, I do suggest raising the sensitivity on the controller to that maximum level, especially if you're used to playing games like Doom on the Switch that require fast movements and things like that. The game is slower than what you may expect for a quote-unquote normal first-person shooter, especially on the Switch. But it is very well done. It is one of the best looking games on the Switch, as you can see from this footage I'm showing you here. Saber Interactive did a fantastic job on this port. And also, if you notice, this game does lean toward a sci-fi narrative and art style. So you could be looking at something that is possible on the Nintendo Switch for something Retro Studios could be doing with Metroid Prime 4, for example. So I do suggest you take a hard look at Crysis Remastered on the Switch, because we don't see games that look like this too often on this console. And obviously this is just a port, so somebody like Retro Studios could definitely take art style like this to the next level and make it look even better, no doubt, on the Switch and whatever else Nintendo is working on in the future when the game does finally come out. And speaking of Metroid Prime 4, now let's get into that information. And I'm excited about this because we may possibly, I want to repeat, possibly have a very good chance of seeing some type of trailer for this game, possibly as soon as this year with how things are going in development. And the latest development update seems to hint possibly towards that. Again, I want to say possibly, don't want to get your hopes up, but from how much things have gone on with the development of this game by Retro Studios, I could definitely see them showing some type of teaser trailer very soon for this game. Of course, maybe in conjunction with announcing Metroid Prime Trilogy. And the reason why I say this is twofold, and we're gonna get into it here. There's a couple different things going on that's very important that you guys should pay attention to, and we're gonna go over it in detail here in this video, that Retro Studios is working on with two separate recent job postings that they are hiring for, which is very telling. A couple things also to remember is that Nintendo themselves announced that Metroid Prime 4 was restarting development in January of 2019, okay? So we're getting close to almost 2 years since that happened. Now, if you recall, if we go back to late 2018, it was rumored, heavily rumored by lots of people claiming they have sources and, you know, backed up sources and things like that, that Metroid Prime Trilogy was going to be revealed at the Game Awards in 2018. And that, of course, did not happen. However, based on the timing of the delay of Metroid Prime 4 restart development in January 2019, it is safe to say that Retro Studios very likely took over development of Metroid Prime 4 back in the latter half of 2018, not when Nintendo announced it in January of 2019. Okay, so let's keep that very clear in our minds when we go over this information, because it is a very key element that people seem to forget. That development for Metro Studios and Metroid Prime 4 very likely, very likely started in 2018, not in 2019. And we're gonna be coming up on the third year of development. And also as far back as 2016, 2015 or so, there was art renders of Metroid by some Retro Studios artists, and no doubt at that time they were most likely planning on working on Metroid Prime in some way for Nintendo, whether it be a Metroid Prime trilogy or like a remaster remake or a Metroid Prime 4. They were planning at some point, and there was talk about it in the Wii U days in 2014 with Miyamoto in various interviews talking about how they would prefer to have Retro Studios do a Metroid Prime 4. So behind the scenes, it seems very likely that Retro Studios was in fact working on some type of concept for Metroid Prime 4 long before the game was even announced in June of 2017 at that E3. Most likely they were planning on working on something Metroid related before that. So putting all that together, Retro Studios very likely already had a very good idea of where they wanted to go in development for Metroid Prime 4 before they were even asked by Nintendo to go ahead and take over production of it. So here we come to today, and we're gonna go over some job postings here that seem to possibly indicate that they may be as much as 75% done with this game, just from the way things are going here, from what we'll take a look at. So on July 15th, 2020, Retro Studios posted a brand new job posting for a contract position for an environment outsourcing review artist. So this person will be reviewing outsourced material. Now again, I want to repeat that this is another contract position they're hiring for the same thing they did back in late 2019. And they also hired an environment outsourcing review artist back then to go over various different content that was being done by different developers that was helping with production in Metroid Prime 4. And basically that job is to bring in that content to Retro Studios and review it and test it in the game itself and to get it running well with the other various assets that they already have and modify it or fix it or what have you to make it work in the game. So it talks about in this job posting, review outsourced content to ensure final deliverables reflect the desired artistic vision, create and or modify existing assets as necessary, provide detailed and organized management of a high volume of assets related to art, ensure ongoing timely feedback to external vendors working on art content, accurately estimate the time necessary to complete individual assets, test levels in-game and assess both aesthetics and performance on the Switch. Collaborate with relevant stakeholders to evaluate external team proficiency in art production. Generate detailed documentation and examples of art asset production, procedures, and engine requirements to support the external vendors. All right, so since this is a brand new contract position, which is of course temporary, they are hiring this person specifically for getting this job done for Metroid Prime 4 in order to get everything working in the game that has been done by outside vendors. And like we discussed, this was done back in 2019 as well. However, now since they're doing it again, it looks like they have a lot more content that has come in that needs to be finalized and put into the game and get everything working smoothly. And no doubt, like we talked about a few minutes ago, since they've been working on this game since 2018, they very likely have a large chunk of this game done and ready to show. Now, why do I say that maybe this game is ready to be shown this year? Well, the reason is not only because they've been working on the game since 2018 and they have a lot of content done, but also for another reason. And another reason is that I found another job posting that Retro Studios late June of 2020. And this was very interesting and got me thinking that this game may be entering the final phases. They have all the gameplay, they have all the art, they have all the assets, they have everything in place, and now they're putting it all together. The reason why I think this is because this job posting is for a concept artist. Retro Studios posted this on June 27th, 2020. Now keep in mind, this is a quote-unquote standard type of artist that they're looking for. They're looking for someone who's good at drawing, someone who's good at concept art, basically. So they're looking for someone to create storyboards, background illustrations, things like that. So Retro Studios may in fact already be planning their next game during the final year of the development of Metroid Prime 4, which is a good idea if they're doing this, which also means that they could be ready to show Metroid Prime 4 very soon, in fact in 2020, because of this. Because usually when a developer already is starting to concept their next game, that means that the current game has already reached their peak level of what they're going to be doing with it, with the planning. Basically everything they have in the works for Metroid Prime 4 is set, and they're going to be developing towards that until basically it's ready to be shipped upon final release. So hiring a concept artist right now, they are actually starting a brand new game here from scratch, which gives me hope that we could be seeing Metroid Prime 4 very, very soon, like we've been talking about this year. And as far as when a trailer is going to be shown for this game, of course, I don't know when that's going to happen. No one knows for sure. Nintendo's been quiet. We all know the very silent nature of Nintendo in 2020. However, they could even have a trailer just sitting there ready to be shown right now, and Nintendo is just waiting for other projects to be ready to show it with, and maybe a direct or a presentation. Metroid Prime 4 most likely does have a demo ready to be shown. They're just waiting on the go-ahead from Nintendo to push the button, because when you compare development time with other games, like Spider-Man, for example, on PS4, God of War, other games, Horizon Zero Dawn, they were shown years ahead of time before they actually were released, and they already looked very polished graphically when they did show those games on PlayStation 4. And when they finally released them, the games were even better in most cases. So for Nintendo to get the ball rolling with Metroid Prime Trilogy, showing a teaser trailer for Metroid Prime 4 is extremely possible in 2020, looking at all the information we've gone over. And going back to what we talked about before, is that this has been most likely a concept and planning for Retro Studios for many, many years now before they even got the go-ahead to even work on this game. That means we could see Metroid Prime 4 as soon as early August, for example, or basically whenever Nintendo gives a go-ahead for them to actually show the game with possibly a big presentation from Nintendo. However, I want to repeat that we gotta keep our expectations in check. We know how Nintendo likes to show things closer to release. For this game, as big as it is, fans have been asking for it for a very long time. and to tease it with a announcement with Metroid Prime Trilogy does make sense, you have to admit. So I wouldn't dismiss the possibility of seeing some type of teaser trailer for Metroid Prime 4 this year. As long as they do finally announce the Metroid Prime Trilogy, this is a very high likelihood of happening, in my opinion. But of course, let me know what you think about this in the comment section. Do you think we have any chance of all of seeing Metroid Prime 4 in 2020 as far as a teaser trailer is concerned, if they do announce Metroid Prime Trilogy? Or if they don't announce anything Metroid related, do you think we could still see Metroid Prime 4 in 2020? Personally, I don't think they would do that. I think it would have to be in conjunction with Metroid Prime Trilogy for them to tease Metroid Prime 4. However, based on the information we've gone over, it looks like this game is in fact ready to show. As far as it being released, I do think the end of 2021 would be the absolute soonest we would see it, but they do need to start showing the game off before that, of course. Just like what we saw with Breath of the Wild 2 being shown and announced at E3 2019, it's been over a year and we haven't had any updates on the game from Nintendo or gameplay footage at all. So they definitely could do this with Metroid Prime 4. They could show it in a brand new trailer and still it could be a year off from that point. It's not out of the realm of possibility. So personally, I'm really, really excited to see this game in action finally. And we've had a lot of information building up. Nintendo will, in fact, show Metroid Prime 4, whether it's in 2020 or 2021. And like I said at the beginning of the video, it's very promising when you see games like Crysis running on the Switch with developers like Saber Interactive doing such a great job on them. It gives me hope for games like Metroid Prime 4 and Metroid Prime Trilogy in the hands of Retro Studios to do something even more amazing on their end, and which we know that they most likely will in fact be making some amazing content for Nintendo. Alright guys, let me know what you think about this in the comment section. It's a lot of information to think about and to go over, so definitely discuss it, let me know your thoughts, and if you did enjoy this video, please hit the like button, subscribe for more, and I'll talk to you very soon in the next video. Have a great day.